गुड मॉर्निंग डियर फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर विक्रांत सुधाकर पाळेकर. आई एम वर्किंग एज असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर इन गोखले एजुकेशन सोसाइटीज आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस कॉलेज जवाहर पालघर. वेलकम इन द सीरीज ऑफ स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री. दिस इज अ सेकंड सेशन वी आर डूइंग. इन द अर्लियर पार्ट वी ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड सम ऑफ द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स रिलेटेड विद द मॉलिक्यूलर कायरलिटी. बिफोर वी मूव इन दिस पर्टिकुलर सेशन, let us have revision of some of the concepts what we have seen. In earlier part, what we have seen is the term related with the stereoisomers, and we have come to know that they have same formula but only the connectivity difference in between the atoms inside the space, and they has one or more stereocenters. What is stereocenter? It is nothing but an atom, basically carbon atom or nitrogen, it can be possible. There are four different atoms attached to it. Then we have tried to understand what is mean by chiral. Chiral is term which is directly related with the non-superimposable mirror images. Remember, for chiral compound, it is a very essential criteria that molecule and its objects, molecule and its mirror image must be non-superimposable. In case of the achiral compound, they get superimposed on its mirror image. Then we have seen very important term, that is nothing but enantiomers. Basically, these are the stereoisomers and they are non-superimposable mirror images of one another. While in case of the diastereomer, they are not mirror images. Okay, next is the optical activity. We have seen most of the chiral compound shows or has ability to rotate plane polarized light. We have also seen what is the concept of plane polarized light. Okay, so remember, optical activity, optical active compound rotates plane polarized light. If it rotates the plane polarized light in the clockwise direction, we say it is a dextrorotatory compound. In a vice versa manner, if the compound rotates plane polarized light in anticlockwise, that is counterclockwise direction, then we say that particular compound is levorotatory. Then in case of the racemic mixture, we have understood that it contains equimolar mixture of two isomers, 1:1 in the ratio. Okay, so these are the some terms which we have understood in the previous session. Of course, these terms will be useful for us in order to understand the further concepts related with the chirality. Now we are going to see different symmetry elements which are present inside the molecules. As we have come to know that presence of only chiral center is not a criteria which will be responsible for molecule to be optically active. Symmetry elements plays very important role. So let us see what is elements of symmetry. Basically, a symmetry element is a point about which a symmetry operation can be carried out, such as mirror plane, that is plane of symmetry, axis of rotation, or center of inversion. If you carried out and such a symmetry operations are present inside the molecule, then we can say that particular thing is related with the elements of symmetry. If any of the above symmetry element is present, that is plane of symmetry, axis of symmetry and center of symmetry is present inside the molecule, then the molecule is achiral, optically inactive or symmetrical. Remember, in order to have the chirality, the molecule need not to have any of one of the symmetry elements. Okay, next, it will be superimposed on its mirror image. If your molecule has symmetry elements, then it will get superimposed on its mirror image. hence it will become optically inactive. Remember this particular term, very important, optically inactive, right? Then remember this thing very carefully. If all the symmetry elements is absent, then the molecule will be non-superimposable on its mirror images, hence it will be called as a chiral and it will exhibit optical activity. So your molecule should not contain any of the symmetry element present, otherwise what will happen, the molecule become optically inactive. So this is a very essential criteria. In order to have the optical activity, the symmetry element must be absent. Remember this thing. Then we will see one by one what are the symmetry element. First is plane of symmetry. Let us try to have the know the definition of it. It is a plane of symmetry, that is a mirror plane, which is basically imaginary, which bisects a molecule into two parts so that atoms or group are mirror images of each other. Suppose there is a such a molecule, and if you try to pass a plane, then what will happen? What are the object and mirror image? They are same. Okay, so this particular thingy is called as a plane of symmetry. Let us consider for this particular molecule. If you see this particular molecule, and if you try to view from this particular way, then if you cut the molecule, which is in this way, which is passing from carbon number 1, carbon and carbon number 2. Let us see this particular structure. So what will I observe? If I pass a plane from atom number 1, carbon and atom number 2, then what will I observe? Left side and right side, they are same. Means I can say left side is equal to right side, that is they are mirror images. So in that case we can say there exists a plane of symmetry. As we already seen, for what is this molecule called as in the previous session, we have seen it is a tartaric acid, and we know that tartaric acid contains two stereo center chiral center, that is asymmetric carbons. So these two structures are mirror images of one another, but they involve none of the symmetry element. If I try to put any plane from passing through this way, it will not have any plane of symmetry. So we can say that this particular molecule is optically active, okay, as there is a absence of any plane of symmetry or any of the symmetry elements. So this is a structure number 1 and structure number 2. Let us try to see another structure, another stereoisomers of tartaric acid. We know that tartaric acid contains 2 asymmetric carbons. So 2^2 is equal to 4 stereoisomers are possible. Out of that, 2 are optically active. Let us see 2 more. This is a mesotartaric acid. So what do you observe in case of the mesotartaric acid? If I pass a plane in between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3, so what will happen? The atoms present on upper side and lower side, they are just mirror images of one another. So in that case, we can say in molecule there exists a plane of symmetry which is bisecting the molecule into two parts. Okay, so object and mirror image, they are same. So in that case, the molecule will show optical inactivity because of the presence of plane of symmetry. Okay, and molecule will be optically inactive. So there exists a plane of symmetry for mesotartaric acid. If there is a question, why mesotartaric acid is optically inactive? The simple answer is because of the presence of plane of symmetry. There exists internal compensation. What is mean by internal compensation? The rotation made by one carbon is cancelled by rotation made by another carbon. Suppose above part is having plus rotation and below part is having minus rotation. So plus minus will become zero. So compound will become optically inactive. So remember for structure 1 and 2, for this two structure it is optically active. For this particular structure it is optically inactive because of the plane of symmetry and internal compensation. Remember plane of symmetry. Definition, example. Then let us try to see the center of symmetry. Center of symmetry. Center. So what is that? It is an imaginary point or atom in a molecule. So that if we try to draw a line, if we try to draw the line, then from that particular line you will observe an atom present on one side and another side equal atoms. In the equal atom is present, then this particular point is called as a center of symmetry. Remember this particular simple concept. So what is observed at equal distance from the center, you will see the same groups which are present. Let us see the example. Suppose the let us see the example. This is structure for 2,4 dimethyl cyclobutane 1,3 dicarboxylic acid. Okay, so this particular compound has four asymmetric center. This carbon, this carbon, this carbon, and this carbon. Okay, so there are four asymmetric center. Suppose if we see this particular point, this particular point. So what you observe from this particular point, if I travel in the above side, there are, I will see COH group. On the equal line opposite side, I will see COH group again. Same is the case at every side. So there exists a center of symmetry. And because of the center of symmetry, this particular molecule will have the optical inactivity, right? Remember, this is the case we need to remember in case of the molecule. Example is 2,4 dimethyl cyclobutane 1,3 dicarboxylic acid. So let us see another example. So this is a structure for molecule dimethyl diketo piperazine. Okay, remember this particular carbon and this particular carbon is asymmetric. So there are four stereoisomers are possible. Apart from that, it also contains two geometrical isomers. One is cis form, another is trans form. So let us see what the difference we can see in case of the optical activity because of the symmetry elements. In case of the cis form, do you find any of the symmetry element present? Or basically center of symmetry, if I travel from this point to this point? No. So what I can observe, there is no center of symmetry. But in case of the trans form, what you can observe? So there occurs a center of symmetry. From this particular point, you will observe that same groups you will observe on both the sides. So we can say there exists a center of symmetry, and this particular thing is very important in order to have that particular molecule to be optically inactive. So in general, we can say that cis form of diketopiperazone is optically active while trans form is optically inactive because of the presence of symmetry elements, even though it is containing four chiral centers. So remember why trans form of dimethyl diketopiperazine is optically inactive. Then let us see next symmetry element, that is alternating axis of symmetry. Go through its definition. Alternating axis of symmetry, it is a line which passes through the molecule around which if the rotation is carried out. Suppose there is a point and around which if a rotation is carried out around, let us say 90 degree or 180 degree, if if we carry out rotation followed by the reflection, if we try to take the reflection of it, so what will observe? Whatever the reflection observed, then mirror image will be same as equal to the original molecule. So basically we can say, what is mean by alternating axis of symmetry? It is nothing but the rotation reflection axis. Okay, so this thing we need to remember in case of the molecule which possesses alternating axis of symmetry. Let us try to see the example of molecule 1,2,3,4 tetramethyl cyclobutane. So this particular molecule has this particular carbon asymmetric, then this particular carbon asymmetric, same means 1,2,3,4, these carbons are asymmetric. If I carry out the rotation around AB axis, this is the same. So what will observe? I will see this particular structure. So in case of the 90 degree means what? This 4 number carbon will come to 1 number, 1 number will come to 2 number, 3 number will become to 4 number. See this particular structure. You can observe in case, in place of the 1, there is 4. In case of the 2, there is 1. In place of the 3, there is 2. So there is a 90 degree. And if I pass a mirror, then what will observe? I will find this particular structure and this particular structure is same. So this particular phenomenon is called as a rotation reflection axis. So what we can say, the molecule which contain alternating axis of symmetry, in case of that, even the molecule has four asymmetric center, that is we can say fourfold alternating axis of symmetry, if we carry out the rotation of structure A through 90 degree along the axis AB, then which is that particular axis must be perpendicular to plane. Suppose in for this particular molecule, this is a plane molecule and we need to pass an axis from its center, that axis must be perpendicular. So in this way, perpendicular, okay, you should not pass axis like this, it must be perpendicular to the plane. So your molecule must be a planar and you can then pass the axis. This you need, we have to remember. Then if you pass that axis, then what will happen? The reflection of this plane is perpendicular to axis. Use structure C. Then structure C and structure A, they are same. So for this particular molecule, what we can say, even though this particular molecule contains four asymmetric carbon, then it is optically inactive or achiral because of the presence of alternating axis of symmetry. So this thing we have to remember. These are the three symmetry elements we have seen till now. So they are very important in order to decide the optical activity of. Let us try to revise the concept what we have seen. So what we have seen, even though molecule contain chiral center, it is not a is a only criteria, it must not have any symmetry elements. Okay, in case of the tartaric acid, we have seen that tartaric acid, two enantiomers are optically active, while meso is optically inactive because of the presence of plane of symmetry. Then let us see another example for the center of symmetry, that is inversion of center. What is the structure called as? 2,4-dimethyl cyclobutane 1,3-dicarboxylase. So there exists a center of symmetry from which at equal distance you will observe same molecules. Then what is the example called as? Diketopiperazine. It has two geometrical isomers, cis form and trans form. You can clearly observe cis form, the placement of the groups, while in case of the transform, there exists a center of symmetry at equal distance, same groups are there. So what we can say, the transform is optically inactive, while cis form there exists no symmetry elements, so it is a optically inactive. So let us see last, rotation reflection center of Suppose this is a molecule 1, 2, 3, 4 tetramethyl. So this is a rotation made. Then we pass the axis. So once you pass the axis, what will happen? The above structure and below structure are the same. Then structure number 1 and structure number 3, they are just the same. So this is a thing we have to remember. So because of this symmetry element, this particular molecule will become optically inactive. So remember this thing, we have to understood this symmetry elements. These are very important in order to decide the optical inactivity. So what is the moral of the study? What we understood from this particular session, even though molecule contain any one of the chiral centers, basically this is a all the symmetry elements what we have seen, it is applicable in case of the molecule which contain more than two chiral centers. So in that case, what you need to check that the molecule contain any symmetry elements, plane of symmetry, center of symmetry or axis of symmetry, we need to check. So if the any of the symmetry element is present, even though it contain chiral centers, the optical molecule become optically inactive, or we can say the molecule is achiral. So this is the thing we need to remember in case of the symmetry element. So once you see the structure, check that the molecule has symmetry elements or not. Go through this particular session, definitely you will understand the things. Thank you very much.